cast and the director of No Exit, the show that will be performed on April 26th and 29th. Can you guys all introduce yourselves and describe your character?
I'm Troy Giacobucci. I play Vincent Credo. I am a evil journalist and husband.
Hi, I'm Danny Lopez, and I play Inez Serrano, and I play a very cold-hearted, rude woman.
I'm Noemi Marin. I play Estelle Delaney, and she is an extremely manipulative and self-centered woman.
Hi, I'm Vicencia Marez, and I'm the director of the show.
Troy and Danny, you just completed the screen comedy Played Against Sam. How was the process jumping from a comedy to a drama?
It's really great. It's challenging, actually. Not in the sense of getting lines or performing, but in the sense of we're going to need to change our whole character aspect and our acting dynamic to something that's going to make everybody laugh and have a great time, to something that'll make everyone think and sit in their chairs and just wonder about what's been going on and what they just saw. Give them something to chew on. It's a very sad environment that we're creating.
Yeah, considering that Played Against Sam was a very farce and comedic play that we had to do, and it was a lot of fun doing it, and then going to the exact opposite from doing like Played Against Sam to No Exit and having to like get really deep into the character and like really be gritty and raw. It's a lot of fun. I really enjoyed the difference between the two.
Noemi, what made your audition for the show?
Well, we were supposed to do it last semester, obviously, and when I heard about the show, I looked up a script and I really enjoyed the dark themes. I'm a person that's very into scripts and shows and things like that that really explore yourself as a person, and I just really wanted to tap into another side of myself when I auditioned for this role.
Placencia, how is directing No Exit different from All the Timing, your first student directed production?
When I first got the opportunity to direct, I wanted to do No Exit because it's a play that I've really enjoyed for a long time. I've always liked the theme and the just how dark it is, but we couldn't get the rights to it, so I did All in the Timing, which was a comedy composed of a bunch of different skits, and it was a lot of fun, but I'm really kind of glad that I'm doing this show as my second year, because when I first started All in the Timing, I was still kind of timid, I didn't really know what I was doing, I was just kind of winging it most of the time, so coming back my second year, I have a plan, I know what I want to do, and it also helps that I've worked with all of them from All in the Timing. So we are close, we take classes together, we're all the same age. So we're a lot closer, and I feel like it really helps for a show this deep.
Placencia, how is it being a student directing peers your own age?
It's a lot of fun. We all respect each other, and when it comes to like blocking and like artistic vision, I just kind of bounce ideas off of them. They tell me their input, and we just kind of meet in the middle. Like, they understand my vision, and I respect them as actors, and having acted with all of them, like, I kind of know, like, they're all really great, and it's a lot of fun.
And how does everyone feel about performing in a black box show instead of the main stage?
That is exciting. It's exciting, and it makes you nervous at the same time, because on a main stage, you have one direction where the audience is, they're right in front of you, but in this black box, they're coming from every different direction, so you need to make sure all of the movements, the expressions, all of the blocking is positioned so everyone gets a fair amount and can view and learn more about the characters through their actions and emotions.
Yeah, considering that like people are so close to you, you really have to like really portray your character because if you're on a main stage and you're so far away, like if you slip up once, like they're not gonna see it. But here, that they're so close, you have to be really in the moment and in your character to portray the play as well as it can be.
And it can be a little bit intimidating, but at the same time, I feel like that we've been preparing enough for it and that we're gonna do a great job with it, in all honesty.
With directing, again, you're not directing from just one perspective. You have to consider the people on this side, up in the corner, like, you know, stuff like that. So instead of like a lot of linear directing, it's a lot of like triangles, circles, making sure that everyone has something to look at, that way they're not, there's no such thing as like a bad scene in the house. Everyone can see something.
What would you all tell someone that wants to see the show?
Somebody that wants to see the show, I'd definitely tell them to come, but to come open-minded, be prepared, because it's not going to be something for them to walk away laughing from, as most of our plays are. It's going to be something for them to think about, and it can get kind of sad. You know, that's something that every audience member should be aware of.
A lot of plays that we do here at WNCC aren't as dark as this one, so I would say to like be prepared for some dark comedic and some serious topics that we go over here, so just come prepared, that's what I'd say.
I agree with Annie, just be prepared, be ready emotionally. I think that as an audience member, you'll want to prepare yourself a little bit emotionally for this because it does hit you really, really hard in places where you don't want to be hit.
Yeah, I definitely think it's a lot. It's a darker play than what our community's used to. There's not a lot of laughs. There's not really a happy ending. It's just really sad. But I also think the message is really great, so definitely come in with an open mind and just be prepared to know that it's not something that's going to make you feel good when you walk out.
That's it.
Thank you.
Thanks. Come see us.
Yeah.